suggest we start. Thank you for coming. We represent Sony Professional Solutions Europe, and we were invited by Christian Genti from Garden Studio to talk a little bit about Sony and cinematography in general. You know that Sony has a long experience in digital video for many years. I would say much before many of our competitors switched from film to digital. And also we have been present in Albanian market for quite a long time, mainly in TV stations. Most of the TV stations I can say that are using our equipment, but not so much in cinema. And that is why we wanted to meet you, to spend some time together, maybe have a discussion, have a hands-on. I have invited my colleague Predrag Bambic from Serbia, who is a very well experienced with Sony technology and cinematography, and he's a cinematographer himself. So I'm sure you appreciate his knowledge sharing, and he can answer a lot of questions. We can go to the next one. Basically, talking about cinema and Sony in cinematography, at the moment, commercially, we believe that we have the best, most complete and most comprehensive lineup of monitors for cinema, production, shooting and creating images. You know, opposite to TV and broadcast people, you are all content creators, and each one of your projects is unique. So you have different requirements in terms of color, artistic color reproduction, artistic look, and so on. Currently, these are the Sony models being on the market. And what I mentioned at the bottom is that all of them from FX3, FX series, FX3, FX6, FX9, FX6 and FX9 we have on tripod presented here. You can touch and try later. Including Burano, Venice 1 and Venice 2 are approved by Netflix. So you know that Netflix has a very precise requirement about the image quality and specification. And if you check on the web, they list by all the brands or approved models. So all of the FX3 to Venice 2 are Netflix approved. So I'm mentioning this in a way that you are, if you decide to use a Sony camera for your product, you are safe with your investment for the future. Venice 1 is not end of life, it is still in on the market. It's filling the gap between Burano and Venice. And the latest one is Burano, basically, the latest edition, which we wanted to have hands on as well, but was a little bit delayed. So if somebody is specifically interested on Burano, you can talk to Christian. Next week you can he can provide, or you can go to his studio and try it yourself. We can switch. Talking about cinematography and production and cameras, you know, it's not only about the camera, it's also very much about the lens. And a few years ago, Sony adopted the one-mount strategy, meaning using the same lens systems for all cinema line camcorders. All the models I mentioned at the beginning are under the cinema line sub-brand of Sony. Currently, we are offering 8 models of cinema line camcorders and more than 72 E-mount lenses by Sony, different specification. And of course, for Burano and Venice 1 and Venice 2 specifically, you can use all the yellow mount 35mm lenses which are on the market. Next one. I didn't want to talk only about the cameras because I'm sure you know very well, but part of the process and very important part is also the monitoring and audio, which I will mention on the next slide. In terms of monitors, we also believe we have a very good range of sizes and specification. not only for viewing, also for field use, for daily zone set, for video control, up to the BVM series for master monitoring, core grading, and core reproduction. Currently going to 31 inch, and I think if you press, maybe the new 17 inch will show up in the middle, in the gap. Christy? Ah, okay. And last but not least, also I know it's not very popular in Albania to use Sony Audio, but for cinema specifically, many of our customers in other countries are using the Sony Digital Dual Wireless System, DWS, as a brand. And for the lower end budget productions and models, the UWP D series, which give you the perfect sound quality, you know, in cinematography, as much as beautiful is the picture and the video, as much as clear and nice you want to hear the audio as well. So that's something you can think about when you make your choice for the cinematography workflow. We do have some units to demonstrate here, including the smart hot shoe adapter to be connected to the camera. Next one. And this photo I selected specifically for the cinema event. This is behind the scenes from Maverick, Top Gun. when we talk about the Venice, one of the unique propositions is the Venice Rialto extension kit. It's a concept where you can dismantle the sensor from the Venice body, and in terms of cable between 3-6 or up to 12 meters, you keep only the sensor inside, in this case, the aircraft cockpit, and the recording part is somewhere outside. It was very much appreciated during COVID when you had to do social distance for the shooting crew, because the action and the actress was happening somewhere and the crew was some meters behind. So that's something also unique to Sony in terms of cinematography product, which has some unique application offered only by us. Without going into any specifications or resolutions or technical details, I will switch to give the floor to Predrag, and he will tell you more about Venice and Burano and his experience with the 35mm products. Yeah.
Good evening, already evening, although it's actually afternoon. My name is Predrag Bandić. I'm a cinematographer, your colleague, and the guy who is using this equipment to tell the stories in a visual way. As Veselin said, he invited me to testify because I, for example, have both of these cameras and I'm using it for different projects. speaking, as Veselin said, I'm very familiar with the Sony technology because I try and do my best to follow the technology that is developing continuously. My personal experience is that I'm working now with the 19th technology since I started. I started as a boy on 8mm, black and white, and then continued with color, with Super 8, with 16 black and white, 16 color, and so on, 35 black and white, 35 color, and so on until present days. You know, I mean, this is the part of our job. That's what I wanted to say. Once we decided to do the cinematography, being that we are heavily dependent on the technology development, we have to follow it. We have to know what are the tools that are available for us for storytelling. So, in my view, I'm using Sony cameras since I believe 92 or something like that, and I had so far many cameras as technology has changed. Currently I own FX6 and FX9. First, of course, because FX9 was first at the on the market, and I'm using it. It in Great Britain, it is being used as a tool for providing quality broadcast footage. In Serbia, we use it mostly for television series, and I personally have used it for 3 feature films with actors, scripted feature films, because the camera has the quality that was appropriate for me and usable for me. Speaking of FX9, which was first on the market before FX6, this is the camera that has the sensor 6K horizontal resolution, which means that with the fact that it writes down the 4K signal in all the iterations, it has a color sampling, oversampling, which means more precise information, which enable us to do more in post-production, in color grading. Also, what is typical for this camera is that it has the sensor which is full frame size. We modern kids call it full frame. We old school call it Leica format or Vista Vision. But it's not limited to that format. It can deliver also a horizontal resolution of 5K, which still maintains the color oversampling with the writing down of 4K horizontal resolution signal picture. Also has the Super 35 scanning mode, which means that we can use the lenses which are designed for APS-C or Super 35 regime. And also in the last firmware upgrade, it has the possibility to scan in a 16mm mode, which makes possible to use the with the appropriate adapter 16mm lenses. I have an old film camera, Aris 16ST, with a set of lenses, and sometimes I'm using it. In that case, being that it's using only the central part of the sensor, it can record only in HD resolution, not in 4K, if you're shooting in 16mm mode. By the way, that same size is very similar to 2/3 inch television sensor, which theoretically makes it possible to use the old television lenses or high quality television lenses for broadcast cameras. I never tried, but I am using 16mm, and especially being that I shot feature films with this camera, I am using 5K mode. Why? Because I have a set of lenses which are designed for 4K Super 35, and they cover that 5K regime of work. And I still keep the color oversampling, so I can precise more precise colors and better, you know, writing of that picture. Camera also has some very convenient features. It has double basic sensitivity of 800 ASA and 4000 ASA. And also it has one thing that by the moment that this camera was made, it has was unavailable on other cameras. It is a continuously variable neutral density filter. That is also the feature that was kept on the other model. It turned out that, you know, between the FX3 and FX30 cameras, which are very handy for the documentary style of shooting, as colleagues said, you know, you are not attracting attention to yourself, you know. It looks like a photo camera, like somebody is snapping pictures. Between those cameras and top of the line, Venice 2, which are the cameras which are being used for the high budget, high profile, well funded, expensive Hollywood films, and that league, all these cameras, which are on other slide, but it doesn't matter. All these cameras have the same style of picture, same style of color. Colorist who is used to work with the Sony Cine Alta cameras are going to easily find the key for color correction of the desired look for or to the camera. I very much enjoyed and loved to have FX9 and to use it for the films, including documentaries. But then FX6 appeared on the market. Well, actually we got the prototype practically at that moment. It was pre-production model. It's not prototype, it's pre-production model. It's already constructed, everything is there, but it's not being made in the volumes as later. And I was amazed because I loved the lightness, the compact size, low weight, which makes it possible to use the camera on gimbals. For example, I use it with Ronin that I had bought. You know, I don't have Ronin 2 or 3. I have the basic, the first one that appeared on the market, because I always wanted as much motion as possible, and it made it possible without hiring, you know, Steadicam operator, which is useful of course, and it's a craft and art and skill for itself, but for smaller things, you know, it's very convenient to use. So this camera with the body, which weighs only 890 grams, and the configuration that it has is very handy for the documentaries. I knew that I have a documentary which is coming to me that I'm going to shoot for 2 years, each month going for 3 days in one remote area of Serbia. So I bought the camera, on which what shocked me at the first moment, on the first test, I pointed the camera in a dark night towards the pitch black sky in unlit of the backyard of the building that has, I mean, backyard of the building in Belgrade. And I recorded externally raw material. In raw format, because it has raw out. And I noticed that something is moving, and I wanted to check out if I have the some artifacts like blocking or something like that. No, it wasn't that. It was a black bird flying on a black unlit night sky. So that shocked me, and I said, I want to have it. And I actually have one of the first delivered to Europe. You know, I love this camera. It's so small, so handy. Everything has, if she has everything, it's very good compression, because it's very advanced technology in compression. I don't want to go into technical details. It's not that interesting. It's small, it's light, it has very high sensitivity. The sensitivity, it has two basic sensitivities, 800 ASA and 12,800 is the other, which can be pushed up to 120,000, something like that. I'm not sure, it's not a precise number. it doesn't matter anymore. The sensitivity is very high, and the noise is very low, and actually it looks like film grain in a way. It is not the same, of course, because it cannot be. There are two different technologies. One is photochemical, the other is electronic. But it looks totally acceptable for me. We can we see that, you know, we have these two cameras which are different and different in price, but there was also the gap between FX9 and Venice and Venice 2. Venice also had 6K originally, 6K sensor. Venice 2 has the choice of if basically it is primarily delivered with the sensor of 8.6K horizontal resolution, and you can also order it with 6K sensor, but hardly anybody does it anymore. So there was a gap. So Sony, towards this springtime, came with solution which called Sony Burano, which has all the advantages of it's using practically the same sensor, the same resolution of sensor as Venice 2, 8.6K, but has some unique features. This feature is, for example, that this is the first camera designed for motion picture production, which has internal in-body stabilization, which makes it very appropriate for very appropriate for solo work, for documentaries, for small crews. It's practically small Venice. It's not Venice, of course, because it is less expensive than Venice. With Venice you get different higher quality, for example viewfinder, or possibility to record internally RAW. Variable ND filter is also the first one designed for the so-called full frame, very similar as in FX9, that idea. Dual base ISO, again, 800 and 3200 ASA, which is far beyond what I imagined that is possible at the start of my career. At the start of my career, standard film, because I was like youngish guy at the times, was 100 ASA, and that's top. But also we used the black and white. I had the plus X. I shot one film in CinemaScope with the lenses which are made, last used the year that I was born, in 1958, with the black and white material 35, which had the sensitivity of basically of 50 ASA, but it was old, it was not fresh, so I had to treat it as 25 ASA. And the film, his name is Odd Night, so it means that the whole film was shot in the night. You can imagine the difference, you know, in ease of work with the camera that has this sensitivity compared to that. You know, it is like light years ahead. Mm-hmm. Burano also has the possibility to record the signal using the XOCN, which is abbreviation for X original camera negative. That's the meaning. What does it mean? It means that, you know, they couldn't use the words Raw because of some legal issues with another producer of film cameras. But also it keeps the possibility to record in XAVC H, it's high profile, 8K. It's more compressed, but it is completely appropriate. It's 10-bit codec, so the files are smaller, and you can still record in logarithmic curve, so you preserve all the dynamic range of 16 apertures, you know, that it has. And so on, and so on, and so on. I'm very unhappy that Burano is still not here. It's stuck in the customs, but we had the promise that on Monday we're going to have that camera. So please feel comfortable to arrange the demonstration to try that camera, and you will see what I'm talking about. It is very important to emphasize that, you know, that Sony's RAW XOCN is 16 bits, not 10 bits, not 12 bits, but 16 bits file. What it means? In 8 bit resolution, we have 256 nuances per color. In 10 bit, we have 1048, or no, 1024, or something like that. Nuances per channel, per color. So we have, you know, 1 billion colors. In 16 bit, we have like 4000 per color. By 4000 by 4000, that's the color resolution of the file. One more, it seems like small thing. Sony has designed what's the name of the mount, e-mount, yes, with the idea to have as shallow flange distance as possible. What it means for us in cinematographer in use, that we can use adapter to any lens that was created before, which led us to the option that we can use the photographic lens, lenses which were designed 20 or 30 years ago, because it has enough space. Burano, when it's delivered, it has only not only E-mount, but it is delivered with very strong PL mount. I, for example, I have the lens sets which are in PL mount. I have the adapter for the 4FX9 and use the same mount with other adapter with FX6. It is possible. It is possible because that short flange back of the lens distance makes it possible. It leaves enough space so you can make the construction which can hold and hold the lens designed for some other format, you know, many years ago. So that's one of the key advantages. Of course, it can shoot in Super 35. Very important thing is that, you know, the media and the communication between the modules and processing of the picture are designed in such a way that it's possible to treat and write down the file shot in 4K 120 frames per second. It's enormous data rate. Normal HD, which means 1920 by 1080, is more than 1 gigabit per second. Almost 2. You can imagine file which is like this is four times the amount of information, or in Burano in 8K, it is 16 times the amount of information times four. So it's 64 times more the information that the sensor, processor, and media, of course, are able to process and write down, which is an enormous technological achievement. So we see this is the Burano is delivered, and Venice, of course. And one more thing that I would like to emphasize, you know, if anybody who decided to be a cinematographer himself decided to be in the endless loop of technological advancements and must be ready to learn as long as they want to do their job. Of course, cameras are only tools. What really matters, once you have the appropriate tool, is what is the story that you want to tell, and the way you want to tell it, and tell it. So, cameras are tools. Those cameras are reliable, extremely sensitive, extremely high quality, well engineered, with proper cooling, without shift in color, which is typical for reds, without the surprises in sudden fails. So you can stop thinking about technology and use it as designed to be a tool for your expression and creativity. Yeah, maybe I should mention the new recording media. For example, the FX6 is using CFX with type A, and Burano is using type B. These cards look different, you know, they are bigger, type B. But obviously it was the choice. It was probably more technological opportunities that it opened, that design of cards. So that's why they shifted. Although this camera also records 4K 120 frame easily, and it works on CFA. But that's probably something that has more with the development of the technology of the IT technology. So this, you can see, Sony is famous for the free upgrades, which open the different options that were previously not developed or hidden from the end user, but at the moment they are opening it, and camera suddenly becomes much more usable than before. For example, the good example, excuse me, so just let me finish the sentence. When it was delivered, this camera didn't have the touch screen and the possibility to drive the focus of the lens remotely by touching the screen. At one moment they opened, announced that there is available the next upgrade, and it became camera with the touch screen and the focus, you know, available, which is very practical. Also, the resolutions of, for example, 16 millimeter scan regime and 5K scan regime did not come originally. There was originally only Super 35 and full frame. Now we have it and use it. So I'm very happy that Sony has that such a policy, you know, that it always opens some new gates and doors, and you can use the camera not in a way that that it was originally designed. Because, for example, I have one, and I still keep it because I shot a lot. You know, there was one Beavicam recorder which was buggy since the day one that it was delivered to me. Correcting it would mean to send it somewhere to deal with customs, and then they would change the EPROM plate, and then the bug would disappear. Then you would get it back, and it would cost you a lot. Now it costs you like 2 minutes of download and 20 minutes of upgrade of firmware. So I invite you to because all these cameras from Cinema Line are designed with the same philosophy, and it is using for film, not for television, not for social networks, not for it. This is using for filmmaking. And have so much in common, not only the paint on the body, you know, but also the deployments of buttons and, you know, the way you can operate, which is important to you because you don't want to think about where is what button, you know, and you simply want to use the camera as fast and as easy as possible. So I invite you to, once we have Burano, to get there and try to test it. You will see what you will get, the results. If there is any question I can quickly answer, please go ahead, shoot.
You feel there is some analogy with Italy, with Venice Film Festival, with Burano Island. We have a range of sealed walls for virtual production, which are named Verona. So Japanese like the idea of to this region, or maybe to go to Italy, but it's also very close, and I think they are very close to your country and your philosophy. And quite a wide choice of lenses, accessories, applications, budgets. So if you decide to work with Sony or to use Sony equipment, you have access to all our know-how and people, and we are not hard to find. You can approach to Christy or Darna Studio, or I also give my contacts to some of you. We are happy to work together to help you. We also encourage collaboration between different production houses or rental houses across the Balkans. So what I want to mention, for example, for Burano and Venice, are sold particularly by serial number to the end user. So we keep track of who is using which unit. So in case you need an extra unit, we can have a kind of referral to where you can find it. We keep rental locator on the web. You can do some joint productions between countries or organizations. I know Albania is very popular for very nice scenario, so many people could be interested to come and shoot here. So we'll be happy to have the contacts, of course, with this team. And all of the cameras can be delivered and found and sold in Albania easily. That's in short. There is a Sony channel on YouTube, Instagram, and you can follow for all kind of reels or applications or video shots. And I believe that this was a very good opportunity to join Darren Fest together, to meet and to talk a little bit about, to mention about Sony, about cinema, about different things which we do, and maybe how it fits into your daily work. There is 5 minutes video at the end. If you are willing to watch, if not, we can just play it, and we can come to the closer to the unit, so you can ask any questions. try and play with the. Thank you.